This video is going to be on how to change the spark plugs on a 2008 Mazda 6. It's the four-cylinder engine, the I base model. And we're also going to go into what to do if you find oil on top of the spark plugs. I've already kind of been in there and I saw that, wasn't sure what to do, so I had to do some research, and now I'm going to go undertake both of those issues. First thing we do is pull off the plastic cover. This is a 2008, like I said, so it just pulls straight up. Some of the later models, I have a 2012 where you have to pull it up in the front and then forward, but on this it's just straight up. There we have it. Next, I like to blow some shop air and kind of clear off the top of the engine. We don't want any debris getting into the cylinders when we remove the spark plugs. My engine probably looks pretty clean because I was under here earlier this morning when I found a problem, so I'll talk a little bit more about that when we get to it. Now we pop off these plastic bracket mounts that hold down that cover, and then also pull the posts off of the coil packs. The plastic covers here are 15 millimeter, and these posts here are 8 millimeter. Now each of those coil packs can be pulled directly out, so we can just pull on the top of them and we'll be able to see down where the spark plug is. The first thing you want to do, particularly on these Mazda 6 engines, is check each of the cylinders, or each of the spark plugs, to see if there's any oil on top of them. So, just pop these out. There's your coil pack. Take a flashlight. Look down here. Now, if you look in here, you can see oil on top of my cylinder. That's not correct. That means that there is a valve cover tube seal for the spark plugs, which is leaking. If you see oil, any significant amount of oil, even a few drops shouldn't be there. If you see that on any one of these four, then you really need to do the valve cover seal replacement. Now, in relation to my vehicle, I have oil in all but one of the cylinders, which is not cylinders, the spark plug slots. So this one you can see is nice and clean. Then you see oil here, you see oil here, and you see oil here. So that's not good for me. So now what we're going to do is change the valve guide seals, and I believe they call them tube seals, for the spark plugs. Basically what we're taking off is this whole plastic cover here. So we need to kind of pull off all these wires, get this stuff out of the way, and then, I mean, it looks actually relatively clean. And then there's a whole number of bolts that pull these off, and then that should pop off, and then we have to put our new seals on. So it doesn't look like it'll be a huge deal. The first thing we're going to do is get these coil packs out of the way. So we've got this, this, and this. They look like they're just slid over the bolts, so we'll pop those guys off and get them out of the way. So on each of these clips, you can see that we have this little tab here and this little tab here. If you can get two of these and kind of push them each to the side, and then a tool something like this to get underneath it, they should pop right up. There we go. All right, so now we've got our coils. Get those out of the way. Next, we'll take off these electrical connectors to get them out of the way. So one, two, three. Little tab right here. That pops right off nice. There's another tab on this one on the top. That pops off pretty clean. And then this guy here. There's a little pop top here, so. Easy, okay. See if we can get this thing out of the way. So these here have similar tabs, so there's two tabs kind of holding onto the bolt like that, so I'm kind of just slowly prying them out of the way, looking down there with a flashlight. It takes forever, but if you don't want to break them, that's the way to do it. I'm sure there's a nice tool that helps with this. And there we are. Just got to do that to the other side as well. Okay. Alright, so need to get this out of the way. I'd rather not undo all these clips if I can avoid it, so I'm going to leave it here for now and move to this item here. I don't know what the story is with this. So we've got these blue clips, these blue clips on either side here. I'm going to try to pry this plastic piece just to get around that, and that'll be the fastest way to get it off. There's one on each side. Right off now. There we go. Get that out of the way. So I wasn't able to get this plastic piece off like I had hoped, but there is this clip here, clips onto this piece here. So you just kind of pry underneath. Now mind you, it's like this. So you're prying down on this tab, which releases this, and then you can kind of pull it off and slide it forward. It's a little tight, but it works. But now that this is off, I think we're okay because we can get to this bolt, which is the key piece. So now we've disconnected pretty much everything we need to get disconnect. Get all this stuff as pulled out of the way as far out of the way as possible. This is gonna be a little challenging. I don't wanna rip all this stuff off, so I'm gonna get the cover to kind of slide over if I can. Now we need to remove 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oop, 7, there's a bracket we're gonna need, 8, 9, 10, and I think there's 11 back here, and then we probably are gonna have to get these two bolts here in the center. So now we'll start working on that. They're all 8mm bolts, so we'll get going on these now. We'll have to come back to that bracket, that's a different size. Okay, now every bolt is off except for this bracket. So once we get that bracket, we should be clear. The bracket is a 10mm. It's actually a nut, so we don't want to lose that. There's another bolt, so we got this nut off the bracket. Now we're going to get this nut off. See if we can get this bracket out of the way. Well, yep, that'll do it. Don't forget there's a bolt underneath that bracket. Before we go taking the cover off, let's just blow the motor off with shop air again. Okay, now we're gonna slowly pry this off. Yep, it's coming. Be careful not to crack anything. All right. Okay, we're gonna have to get this out of the way. So we're gonna take off this here and somehow undo this from here, then we should have enough play to get this off. Start with this, squeeze, that pops right off, it's nice and easy. Just gonna try to bend these tabs in. Yeah, that's gonna work. There we go. There we go. Okay, now we're definitely gonna have the space we need to get this baby off. Dipstick's got to come with it. All right, what do you know? The inside of an engine. The problem that we are trying to fix is the oil that is showing up in here and in here, and then this one happens to not be leaking. So what's actually happening is there's a seal that goes around this little square here. There is a bigger seal that goes around this rectangle, and then a seal that goes around this smaller area. And then of course the entire valve cover seal goes all the way around the outsides. So the problem was is these two failed, and that's why we're getting oil in there. And yeah, that's pretty interesting. That's actually the camshaft. So now what we need to do is here is the valve cover. So we have a seal that goes all the way around the edge, and then these are those three seals. So I bought a seal pack and we will replace them. Okay, so now what we need to do is get the old seals out. So again, we've got the one that goes all along the perimeter here. Then we've got the 1, 2, 3 here. So we got these little pick tools and we're gonna slowly work our way around until we get all this out. You wanna be careful though, you wanna be digging holes into too much of this stuff because you don't want to leak. Now we want to go through and we want to clean out these channels to get as much oil out of there as possible with paper towels. And now that we're cleaned up, get our new seals. Okay, hopefully this is the right one. It should be. Looks like this is gonna go here. And the way these went on before is there's kind of a thicker end, so it gets just kind of a thin end and then a little bump and then a little bit thicker at the top. The top is what's going upward, so we'll install those. We are prepped to put this back on from the cover side, and now we need to prep the engine. What we need to do is clear out the top here. Whoops. The top right here, although that seal was working, and we got to get all the oil out of this area here and all the oil out of that area there. Once we do that, we'll be ready to put the new seal on. Depending how much oil you have, you could use a turkey baster or something to get oil out, which is what I'm doing. I'd like to get as little oil as possible going into the cylinders. You don't want oil on the sealing surfaces, so we need to wipe that down in every area where the seal touches, which is each one of these three spark plug seals and the outer overall valve guide seal. Also be careful because this kind of, the machining on the block is not, they don't do a break edge, so there could be some sharp edges from the machining. I haven't cut my finger yet, but I'm sure it's coming. Also use care to wipe outward from here, outward that way, because we really don't want anything in here. This is the actual, you know, camshafts, you know, dirt would not be good for them. Here's your timing chain, which is nice because we don't have to replace those generally. I think I've got it cleaned up as best I could. I went in there with a paper towel. I went in there with the turkey baster. So I also went around all these edges. I cleaned these up as much as possible. Got the oil off. Got the oil off in the center pieces or the center seal seats. So I think we're ready. Now we can change the spark plugs. The spark plugs on this car are 5/8. I highly recommend the magnetic spark plug sockets. The ones with those rubber ends are not good, in my opinion, because they can get stuck. Although it's a lot easier when you have the valve cover off, because, you know, getting a hold of the spark plug's not a big deal from here. See all the oil? Now I'm just gonna go in, clean out those holes, get as much oil as I can out of those first three, and then we'll put the new ones in. I'm going with NGK spark plugs. They're laser iridiums. They are 90083s. I believe the gap is preset, and it looked like it was about 0.49, somewhere in that area. I was trying to figure out the spec, and it looks like it's somewhere between 0.46 and 0.5 something, but you might want to verify that. Mine are all at 0.49, so I'm going to go with that. Always put the plugs in by hand, meaning without the wrench. Cross-threading the plugs would be bad. Some people put anti-seize on them. I've seen mixed reports on that, so I'm not. This car is 100,000 miles, by the way. It's the first time I've touched the car, quite frankly, other than brakes. All right, so that's just hand tight for now. You should really torque the spark plugs. I was struggling to find the exact specification, but it looks like 14 foot-pounds, so that's what I'm gonna go with. I've got kind of an inexpensive wrench, which I'm not particularly fond of, but we'll go with that. There is a crush gasket, so it's gonna feel a little odd. Yeah, it doesn't seem like much pressure, honestly, at 14, or 15 rather. I'll probably snug them up a little more than that, because I don't know, it doesn't feel too tight. This wrench is also too big for the job. I'm at the lower end of the scale. You really don't want to do that. I'm going to snug them up just a bit. Maybe it's not too bad. I just went like an eighth of a turn. You definitely don't want to overdo it. Strip the threads out of the aluminum block. That'll ruin your day. All right, so we're ready to put the valve cover back on. Here we are, all cleaned up. This side is gonna go over there. See if we can do this as cleanly as possible. The biggest struggle is gonna be this piece right here. Once we get through that, it should be straightforward. That looks okay. This bracket's the other piece. That's out of the way. Okay. Let's see if we can get a bolt started. You want to kind of get them all started before you go snugging anything down. Alright, snug this up. Had a little trouble with this bolt right here. You might want to start with that one. For some reason it was a little bit off, and it's stressing the cover just a little bit to get into place. Okay, I'll just do a final snug on all the bolts. So we got one on the end, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9, whoop, 10, 11, 12 and 2 in the center. 13, 14. Okay, now we'll get our wiring back in place. Should be much easier than it was getting off. Start with this, just pops right on. Pops right on, that's good. This goes into this little clip here. Good. Don't forget to reconnect this. The little, you know, weird looking side goes on the outside. That's in. All this stuff is where it was. We don't need these just yet. Plug this guy in. Good. I'm gonna get this bracket on in the back. I'll move the camera over for that. Alright, we get this bracket together. There's two bolts. First we get it clipped on here. And then if they say we start with this, so the bolt is here. And that was a 10 millimeter. Just snug, and then the nut on top, again, a 10 millimeter. Once that's snug, get this hose back on. This pops in here, and this. Just lock in place. Just get these little arrows into that slot there. Okay. Good. All right, that's all set. This guy, which was giving us a tough time, we gotta get on this little bracket. Oof, it's gonna be tight. Through here. Okay, nothing missing, nothing loose. We put our coil packs on, so again, the spark plugs are replaced. One, two, three, four, and these slip over these little connectors here. For those of us that removed this before, all nice and in place. Why does this feel? I guess they're not that snug. Okay. We should remember to put our dipstick back. Bolt down our coil packs. The clean ones, you'll see some are clean and some are dirty. The clean ones go on 4 and 2, and the only reason I'm saying that is because those are the ones that are covered by these plastic guys, so the other ones look a little bit more corroded. Not critical either way. Get these on. Okay. I think we're still 7 millimeter. Yes. Snug, not murdered. All right, little plastic guys on here and here. This is a 15 millimeter socket. Tighten these much, they're just sitting there. Okay, final check. Oh, missed a plug. Plug this guy back in. Okay. Sorry, I didn't realize I had the camera pointed at the bracket zoomed in. So all we did again is put our coil packs in, these guys, on 2 and 4 for the plastic, 15 millimeter. Don't forget this connector, this connector, this connector, this little connector over here, this connector over here. Other than that, just pop these cables, plastic on these on the bolts. They just kind of slide on, and that's about it. Make sure everything's nice and tight. All right, so now we'll clean the engine and check to see, make sure everything's running. Seems pretty good, that's good news. For those of us, by the way, that did have the oil on top of the spark plugs, you're probably gonna get a little bit of smoke for the first few minutes because it's gonna burn off whatever residual made it into the engine. From there, we just pop the cover on. And we are in business.